Back in 2017, I made a video called What's the Oldest Country in the World? The video obviously contained a lot of different dates, both as far back as 5,000 years ago, right up to and including the modern era. During my research for that video, I noticed absolutely no consistency with regards to dating notation. Some sources used BC and AD, while other sources used BCE and CE, despite referring to the exact same dates. I wasn't sure which one to use for my video, so I did some quick reading on the issue and ultimately went with BCE and CE because apparently it was more academic and modern, although I didn't really think much of it. When the video was released, however, I began to notice a lot of negative comments about my use of this particular dating notation. I was surprised to see that people were calling me out for being overly PC and that I should just use BCAD like a normal human being, to quote one comment. So I decided to take an even deeper look into the topic and found that it's actually a surprisingly controversial issue. Most people are probably already aware what BC stands for, before Christ. AD is definitely less well known. It does not stand for after death, as I used to think growing up. It stands for the Latin Anno Domini, taken from the full original phrase, which translates to in the year of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the other hand, BCE stands for before the Common Era, while CE stands for the Common Era. BCE and CE use the same numbers as BC and AD, with simply a change to the nomenclature. This dating system was actually devised some 500 years after Jesus by a monk known as Dionysius Exiguus, using the supposed year of his birth as the transition point between the two eras. It isn't actually known how Dionysius established this year though. More modern predictions put the year of his birth somewhere around 6 to 4 BC, as ironic as it sounds. Regardless, the year Dionysius thought to be the birth of Jesus is the one that stuck. Anno Domini was popularised by an Anglo-Saxon monk known as Venerable Bede in his work The Ecclesiastical History of the English People, completed in the year 731. In this same work, he also used the phrase before the time of the Lord's incarnation to refer to the time before Anno Domini. This would eventually develop into the before Christ that we use today, but was not adopted until several hundred years later. The Anno Domini system was endorsed by the Holy Roman Emperor Charlemagne, and would later be officially adopted by the Roman Catholic Church. By the 15th century, the system was used all across Europe and beyond. Now, the BCE-CE abbreviations are, of course, much more recent, though perhaps still older than you might expect. The term Common Era can be traced all the way back to 1615 and 1635 in English as the Vulgar Era. The meaning of the word vulgar has changed considerably in the last 400 years. At the time, it just meant normal, ordinary, or, of course, common. Common Era can first be found in English in 1708, but it wasn't until the mid-19th century that its usage began to become more widespread as it was popularised by Jewish religious scholars. This was in order to avoid explicitly referencing Jesus as our Lord using the Anno Domini abbreviation AD. In the later 20th century, the terms BCE and CE were further popularised in academic and scientific publications, as well as by those who wanted to emphasise sensitivity to non-Christians. The usage of BCE-CE notations has been growing in recent history, especially within the last 2 or 3 decades. It has become the standard for academic papers, although it's by no means universal. Many countries, or regions within countries, have chosen to switch from teaching BC and AD to BCE and CE in their primary school curriculum. Of course, these switches were never without their controversies. So, which one should you use? Well, first and foremost, I should emphasise that neither system is wrong. Both methods are perfectly acceptable. It's impossible to please everyone, and there will always be people who have objections to the use of one or the other. At the end of the day, it all comes down to opinion and personal preference. The main argument for the use of the newer, more politically correct abbreviations is that in the modern, multicultural society that we live in today, the exclusion of Christ from the terminology is a more neutral, inclusive way of notating the years. The motivation here is that the word Christ isn't technically a proper name, it's actually a title that directly relates to the traditional Judeo-Christian concept of Messiah. In that sense, there are plenty of people that would be uncomfortable referring to Jesus as Christ, even if they can accept using him as a historical reference point by convention. However, there are many counter-arguments that are frequently raised. Some view the gradual change away from the traditional BC-AD system as completely unnecessary, or nonsensical even, and at the extreme end, an attack on Christianity. So while the new notations are an attempt to be inclusive, neutral, and sensitive to non-Christians, there will obviously be those that are unhappy with the change too. It's not just Christians that don't like the change, of course. Many are of the opinion, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. It is seen by many as solving a problem that doesn't exist. Today, in the 21st century, we live in a more secular society, so it's sometimes easy to forget just how much of everything around us is named after religion. It's ingrained into the fabric of our society. Just look at the days of the week, or the planets of our solar system, mostly named after Roman or Greek deities. Of course, the influence of Christianity is a lot more significant and immediate than that of the ancient Romans and Greeks, so it makes sense that people would have a bigger problem with explicitly Christian motives in a secular society. That being said, the actual name of the calendar, the Gregorian calendar, is named after a pope, Pope Gregory XIII. Therefore, it could be argued that it is a Christian calendar, and trying to use it without any mention of Christianity is an effort in futility. After all, curious school children being taught the BCE-CE method are inevitably going to ask, so when does the Common Era start? Why on that year? Which leads right back to the very thing that was trying to be avoided in the first place. So changing the letters doesn't really change much. The numbers are still exactly the same. They're still based on the birth of Jesus, albeit a slightly incorrect approximation of the birth. There are, of course, other calendars that exist today. The Jewish community have the Hebrew calendar, the Chinese have the Chinese calendar, and Muslims have the Islamic calendar, for example. But due to how widespread the Gregorian calendar has become, these calendars are generally used alongside the Gregorian calendar, which is generally used as the civil calendar as a matter of convenience. Another objection to the change is to do with language and how it evolves over time, and especially from Latin. Much of Latin that has found its way into English, and plenty of other languages, has lost a lot of its original meaning. Take the months of the year for example, September, October, November, and December. Now these should be, according to their original Latin meanings, the 7th, 8th, 9th, and 10th months, but they're not. We just know that September is the 9th month because that's what it is. The same argument could be made for the AD abbreviation. The original Latin meaning is so far removed from its everyday usage. How many people even know what AD stands for, and how many of those people even know the English translation? There is one example of another initialism, one that has not been changed despite changing times, the NAACP. The NAACP stands for the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People. It's an organization that was founded by African Americans for African Americans, founded in the United States in 1909. Now today, the term coloured people is far from an acceptable term to use, and would generally be met with a very negative reaction if used in conversation. That being said, the organisation has kept the same name, despite the now out of date terminology. The same argument could be applied for the BCAD controversy. The letters are just still used out of tradition and a lack of a real reason to change them, even though what the letters stand for may not be all that modern. From what I can tell, one of the biggest objections to the newer dating notation is not so much that people are using it, but rather those who try to force it upon others or want to make it an official universal standard. For example, Wikipedia's manual style states that both BCAD and BCE-CE are acceptable. However, there have been proposals to make BCE and CE the Wikipedia standard for all articles except for those that are directly related to Christianity. There are some other objections that could be made about the specific proposal of BCE and CE itself, some of which are on a more practical level rather than a religious or emotional one. Firstly, and perhaps most crucially, BCE and CE are much easier to misinterpret than its traditional BCAD counterpart. BC and AD have no letters in common, also BC comes after the year while AD should technically be placed before it. On the other hand, BCE and CE are much more similar, with obviously the former containing both the letters of the latter, with just the first letter B as the differentiating factor. BCE and CE also both come after the year. Let's look at a practical example to demonstrate how confusion may arise. Take the two following years, 2003 CE, 2000 BCE. Again, that's 2003 CE and 2000 BCE. Phonetically, the only difference between these two dates is the one between the THR and the B sounds. Literally one part of one syllable could mean being off by more than 4,000 years. Also, BCE-CE is a combined 5 letters, whereas BCAD is only 4. This may sound incredibly minor, but if you're saying multiple dates over and over again, those extra syllables can really add up. There is also another potential cause for confusion. The abbreviation CE used to have an unfortunate alternative meaning, the Christian era. In fact, the two terms Common Era and Christian Era were initially both used interchangeably. Now, one potential solution to the disagreement that I thought was quite interesting by a YouTuber named Lindy Beige was to simply change what the letters mean for those who want to remove the reference to Jesus. He suggested that BC could stand for backwards chronology and that AD could stand for ascending dates. Of course, I realise this probably wouldn't be satisfactory to those who have objections for religious reasons. It's almost certainly too late for something different anyway. BCE and CE are extensively used throughout academia and far beyond. Unfortunately, it seems like one of those issues that people will just fundamentally disagree on, and I really don't see a general consensus being reached, at least not anytime soon. I'm going to end this video off with my own personal take. To be honest, I was a little bit surprised by just how strongly held some of the opinions are with regards to this issue when I first started researching it. I grew up learning BCE and AD, and even though I did switch over to BCE and CE for my video about the oldest country in the world, in hindsight, I think I'm just going to stick with what I originally learned. It should go without saying that I don't think anyone should be judged by which set of abbreviations they use. At the end of the day, they are both correct, and there's no reason to get worked up about other people's preference in this regard. BCE and CE are used to be sensitive towards non-Christians. As a non-Christian myself, I don't really feel the need for the change, even though I can appreciate that others might. In my opinion, the alternative dating nomenclature set out to do one thing, remove reference to Christianity, but it doesn't even do that very well. The numbers are still the same, so they're still based off of Jesus, and the calendar itself is still named after a pope. Trying to make a change, given how minor the issue seems to me, just feels unnecessary. Of course, I don't speak for all non-Christians, and I know that the use of this terminology might make some people uncomfortable. I would have no problem using BCE and CE in certain circumstances in the future, if I'm talking about the history of Judaism or Islam, for example. In pretty much any other circumstances though, I think I'll continue to use BC and AD, as that's what comes most naturally to me.